Once the LAB-X5000 is switched on, you have the possibility to log on in three different levels. So we have the normal operator level, we do have the advanced operator, and we do have the manager. First, I want to show you how to log in as a normal operator. When we have a look to the software, we can scroll down, and on the left side, you can see the fast icons. One fast icon is the font size. So when we have a look to our measurements, this is a normal view. And when we enable the font size, you will see the results in bigger size. The other fast icon is to log out of the software again. Now we can log in again as an advanced operator. And when we scroll down, you will see we have much more possibilities for the fast icons. The fast icon for font size and logout you know already at this point. So I will show you the fast icon for the auto printing, for example. When this fast icon is enabled, directly when your measurement has finished, the results will be printed out with the internal printer. When the sample naming is enabled, you have to give, after pressing the start button, first a name to your sample before the measurement starts. The pass/fail icons enables or disables a view that the instrument shows you that your results are out of a range which you give before to the instrument. The last icon is the standard deviation. So you can enable or disable to see the standard deviation for your results. And we do have an icon for wireless LAN. So we have the possibility to switch the Wi-Fi on or off. When the Wi-Fi is enabled, you have the possibility to send your results directly to an external cloud or to your server. So let's go back to the start view. This video shows you how to perform routine analysis with the LAB-X5000. You can measure various samples with this instrument. So for example, you can have liquid samples in such sample cups. You can have powder samples also in the sample cups. You can prepare press pellets from your powder samples. And these press pellets can be put in this special holders to measure them in our analysis pod. Or you can have film samples, for example here, silicon on paper. In our case, we want to measure phosphorus in liquid samples. And for this, first, we put a secondary safety ring with an additional film on it in our analysis pod. And then we put our unknown sample, phosphorus in liquids, also in there. In the software, you can see which calibration is selected, so the phosphorus and liquids calibration, and we can select different icons. So in our case, I want to see the standard deviation, which is enabled, and I want to have the auto printing so that the results directly will be printed when the measurement has finished. Now I press the start button, and the sample is turning to the measurement area. In the software, you can see when the measurement conditions has been set, that the time is going down from 30 seconds to zero. You can see directly a live result with the standard deviation. When the measurement has finished, the sample will come back to our starting point. You can take it directly out of the instrument and you see the results on the auto printing. These results can be now attached to our unknown samples.